Hey, pre-sales professionals, it's James Kaikis back. Part two of our five-part series on the podcast in January 2022. If you missed last week's episode, please spend 10 minutes with me as I discuss our From the Founders update, give my perspective on Pre-Sales Collective and what is to come in our amazing profession and around our amazing community for 2022. Today's episode is really about the shift in B2B sales. In my last episode, I reflected back on my executive summit presentation. And so I would encourage you to go to our YouTube and watch some of the sessions from the executive summit. But mainly, I want to talk about the change happening in B2B sales. As Garen Hess, CEO and co-founder of Consensus, calls it, buyer enablement. And you're starting to hear more about buyer enablement. And it's because the sales process is shifting to the buying process. And why is that happening? Well, a lot of trends in B2C are bleeding into B2B, whether you want to believe it or not. The same person who is going to buy your software also shops on Amazon. They utilize Uber and Lyft. And as Sean Whiteley from Qualified.com says, Uber and Amazon have changed the concept of speed and personalization for all of us. So whether you buy into the product-led growth trend or not, at the end of the day, people are doing their homework. Gartner, Forrester, a number of analysts give different percentages about how far somebody is before they even enter your sales process. We're talking 50, 60, 70% of the way done with their evaluation by the time they talk to the seller. That's really interesting. And if we actually look at the LinkedIn report on sales from 2021, there's some really interesting data points that I'd like to highlight because I believe that is the reason why the pre-sales professional is the future of sales. If you look at McKinsey's data on self-service by B2B companies, you would see that the number of companies and number of individuals in evaluations has increased from 2016 to 2019 and 2019 to 2022. The number of people that are doing self-service in B2B evaluations is increasing tremendously year over year. Because again, people want to go do their own homework. They don't trust salespeople. It's crazy to think about, but LinkedIn's state of sales report for 2021, 60% of people think that salespeople are not trustworthy. That is alarming. And if you actually look at the seller perspective, 65% of sellers said that they always put the buyer first, but only 23% of buyers actually agree with that statement. Let me repeat, 65% of sellers say that they always put the buyer first, but only 23% of buyers actually agree with that statement. Okay, there is obviously a disconnect here. Let's be super transparent as sales engineers. Sales is hard. If you're a salesperson and you have quota, there are so many things that we ask our salespeople to do. And I think the best pre-sales professionals have empathy and understanding for those sellers because they are on quota. They live and die by their quota and their success. There are so many things we ask some of our sellers to do. Why am I bringing that up? Because that actually affects what they're doing on the sales calls. How many times has a pre-sale professional walked into a room with a seller and the seller introduces themselves and said, this is my smart sales engineer. They're going to lead the call. Those sellers have hurt their credibility right then and there. And that is what we need. We need team selling to happen to be successful. Because if you actually ask buyers what kills deals, based off the LinkedIn State of Sales report in 2021, 48% of folks say that salespeople who provide misleading information on their product or pricing, they kill deals, 48%. Second was 44%, not understanding my company and my needs. And 43% was not understanding our own products and services. So going back to my first statement, if a seller walks into a room and doesn't have a point of view and doesn't have a perspective, it is going to hurt the deal. You already are behind. And the top five reasons of why people buy, according to that same LinkedIn report, trust in brand of product and services. And number two is trust in relationship with sales team. That is so important. Number three was price. Number four was ROI. And number five was service after sale. So what is happening in B2B sales is that sellers are being asked to do so many different things. And if they don't come with a perspective to how to help that buyer buy their software, because that buyer has already done their homework and it's already down the sales process, then this buyer is not going to purchase that software. The sales teams that come with a point of view, that work in tandem, that have a strong relationship, will be the ones that are successful. And what does this have anything to do with pre-sales professionals? If you ask so many leaders, what makes a pre-sales professional? They talk about trust. I like to call it a customer-centric problem solver. Our job is to put the customer first and help solve their problems with or without our software, help them in their processes. And that is the change that is happening with the sales engineer. Is it business savvy? Is it tech savvy? Those are questions and topics that we've had around the PreSales Collective because the role is changing. It is shifting from a sales assistant to a true co-pilot, from reactive in the sales process to proactive, and from an order taker to a real strategic asset. And that's because pre-sales professionals are at the center of influence. Pre-sales professionals, for better or for worse, are involved in so many aspects of the business. And many times they're not comped or evaluated on all those touch points within the organization. But that is why this is such a valuable resource. And if we think about pre-sales is growing. The ecosystem is forming. I talked about that last week. Again, open roles, number of companies popping up to build products for sales engineers. And the VC investment has increased month over month. It's unbelievable. It really is. And this ecosystem is forming because people are finally understanding how important it is to unlock the potential of pre-sales professionals. You know, as we talk about this role, there are not enough pre-sales professionals out there. Whether you call it the Great Resignation, the War for Talent, Wall Street Journal dubbed 2022 as a year for the dream job, there is such high demand for this profession, such high demand for curious, trustworthy, customer-centric problem solvers. And if you want to approach the role as we did 10, 15, 20 years ago, that's not going to work in today's modern buying environment. Sales is changing and pre-sales professionals are on the forefront of that. This is also why Pre-Sales Academy exists. We exist because we're trying to bring in new talent. How many folks say, oh, well, they're not technical enough or they didn't have enough experience? There are facets of this job that translate from curiosity or owning an IT technical platform or being able to present in front of folks or having great executive command. These are things that you can't necessarily train folks, but you can train them on their technology. And so we need to do our part to bring more people into this amazing profession. And as the profession grows, we have to set some standards. I bring these examples up so often, but it's true. There are folks that come into the Pre-Sales Collective that have been doing this for 1-2 decades, asking questions on KPIs and capacity planning and alignment models. And so we need to put some things out there that allow this profession to grow and scale within a specific framework that allows for consistency across organization, but also allows the flexibility as well that the role could be customized for an organization. With Pre-Sales Collective, we want to be able to lead the way in setting some of those standards. We want to be able to show what good or what great in sales engineering looks like. If you're starting a sales engineering org from the ground up, we want to help provide you that framework, give you those resources, help you along the way because there's so many people who've already done it before. This is what we are emphasizing for 2022. We're going to continue to bring more perspective toward the forefront for the profession. As I mentioned in last episode, if there's ways that you want to get involved, PreSalesCollective.com contribute. You can raise your hand to sign up to get involved in one of our mediums. You can nominate someone. We want to put out quality content that moves this profession forward. Sales is broken. Buying is the new emphasis. We need to figure out how people want to buy and alter our go-to-market strategies around that. And it's no longer the straight salesperson anymore. This is where sales engineering is so important in the future of sales and the future of buying, especially when we look at product-led growth. And so Pre-Sales Collective is committed to helping raise this profession, to help build the ecosystem, provide the resources, and bring the energy to these conversations so that pre-sales can get its strategic seat at the executive table as buying shifts. There is a shift happening in B2B sales, and we might be biased, but we believe pre-sales professionals are at the core of this. Our role is no longer just about demoing. We're not just the technical person in the sales process. We are a true co-pilot because selling is really hard and buying is tough. And when you have a team that's in lockstep that will help a buyer move through a sales process with trust and confidence and information, you have success. Again, we are absolutely committed to helping create and form an amazing ecosystem around pre-sales professionals. So if you want to get involved, pre-sales collective.com. kaikis.com/contribute. We're encouraging you to get involved. We want to continue the conversation around this topic. What does buying mean to you? What trends are you seeing change that you believe that PreSales Collective should be aware of? Where do you believe the pre-sales professional should fit in go-to-market organization? And where should it fit in the strategy? We'll continue to talk about this topic throughout 2022. All right, Pre-Sales Collective, if you have any thoughts, considerations, or feedback, you want to continue this conversation, please reach out to me at Slack. If you're not part of the Slack community already, presalescollective.com/Slack, and I will see you next week.